Welcome back guys, Mark here. If you are wondering what is HSL color panel in Lightroom, how to use it in practice, or maybe you just need more control over the colors than saturation and vibrance can give you, then in this video you will find the answers and some useful tips how to use them in practice. Let's go to the Lightroom. So, HSL color section is fourth panel in development module in Lightroom. There are two different views, HSL and color. Let's firstly focus on HSL, but before we will go into the details, I would like to explain you the difference. If you are using basic sliders like saturation, so you are impacting on every color on the screen. Similar situation is its vibrance. It's impacting on every color on the screen in a bit different way than saturation, but for every color. But what is the difference in HSL? In HSL, you can focus on every color separately. So for example, if I would like to change hue of reds, then I'm going to that slider. And if I'm going left, you can see it became pink. If I'm going opposite, you can see it is orange. So you could see I impacted only on reds, but didn't touch blue and green. Of course, the same I can do with blue, for example. So I think this is quite clear. Similar situation is with saturation. You can see, let's assume I would like to change saturation of blue this time. So I'm going down and going up. You can see I'm impacting only this color. And as you can imagine, similar situation is with luminance. Let's take right now greens. I'm going down and this is darker, and going up and this is brighter. Okay, but impacting only this one color. Okay, so that view is my favorite one. But as you can see, so here is selected all. But I can change the view a bit. I can work separately on hue for every color, saturation and luminance. Effects are exactly the same. This is only a matter how those sliders are organized. And if I will switch from HSL to color, then I will have similar situation. I mean exactly the same possibilities, but organized in a bit different way. You can see right now, I see every slider like hue, saturation, luminance, but relevant only to reds. The effect is exactly the same, but organized in different ways. So if I would like to impact on blue, for example, I need to click blue and I can work on that. But what may be useful for you is the last option here. You can see in one panel, we see every color we saw earlier here. Okay. But again, organize differently as this is grouped by color. So this is up to you. I personally prefer this view. In this section, I have also quite interesting option here, and I will explain it to you a bit later. And right now, let's go to the live examples. I will show you how you can use those section in practice. So guys, you can see landscape here. I already made some basic corrections. So this is raw and this is with some basic corrections. What I did is I used mostly basic section, but if you are interested how I'm editing landscapes, please check my other videos. Here we will focus only on the colors in HSL and color section. So as you probably notice, color here are a bit flat. Let's do something with them. Firstly, what we can do, we can focus on sky. So this is not a surprise for you. If I will tell in sky, we have a lot of blue. And of course, we can try to manipulate with saturation. It is changing, definitely it is changing, but I think the effects are not super beneficial. But let's see what will happen if I will focus on luminance. And this is something what I used to do. You can see I'm putting down the luminance and it is giving me a lot of details in the sky. Of course, it depends on clouds and the weather, but for that picture and many others, you can see it is very beneficial, at least per my view. If we are focusing on trees and grass, we can mostly manipulate with yellow and green. So for example, if I will increase yellow a bit, okay, so it's impacting also on grass, but I can increase luminance of grass or decrease it to make it stronger. So I decrease luminance of greens, increase saturation of greens, and again we'll try to adjust yellows, maybe even we'll make them more bright. Okay, maybe a bit more. Okay, so you can see the picture right now is much more colorful. This was before and this is after. Before, after. Okay, so I think it was quite beneficial. But if you would like to work a bit with hue, you can change the style of that picture. For example, this is spring, but if you would like to move the style of that spring more into autumn, you can work with hue for yellow and greens. Please see, I'm moving yellow into left, I mean hue of yellows, and you can see the impact is quite big. I think looks a bit not natural, so I can help also with greens. Okay, so here. Okay, and in that quick way, we change the style of that picture. I prefer the previous version, so I'm getting back with those sliders. Okay, one more important thing. As you can see here, there is no too much orange. But what you need to know, the orange is impacting really strongly skin. So if we have people in frame, then impact will be significant. So I'm going to show you. You can see two persons and I'm going with luminance of orange down and up. So you can see more places are impacted, but skin is impacted really, really strongly. So working with orange is a good way to adjust color of skin. And last thing, but definitely not the least. So let's switch firstly to our picture before we edited colors. As you remember, I showed you those icons, and right now I will show you how it works. So if I click on that and I would like to change, for that case, saturation of grass, I'm clicking on grass and still pushing the button. And if I'm moving up or down, you can see Lightroom is changing both sliders, yellow and green. This is because in grass we have both yellow and green, but you can see how it is doing that. So it is not going with the same speed, it is going proportionally. So Lightroom found that in the place I clicked, there were more or less two times more greens comparing to yellows, and the Lightroom is changing it proportionally. Of course, the same applies if we will go with luminance. So let's click again and let's click on the grass maybe. So you can see also both sliders are impacted, also proportionally. And if you would like to change sky, you can see for sky, mostly there is blue and a bit of aqua as well. So guys, you could see that HSL section can give you a lot of benefits, and this is really, really simple. Probably you need to have some practice, but this is really a powerful tool. I hope that video was useful for you. If you have any remarks or questions, please leave them in comments. I also appreciate if you will let me know what kind of videos you would like to see next. Also, I appreciate if you click like button and subscribe to my channel to see more videos like that in the future. Thank you very much, guys.